Hey, what's up guys, KSK here. Welcome back to another video. In this video, I will show you how to dual boot Linux Mint with Windows 11. This guide is one of the safest ways to set up a dual boot on any PC or laptop without any data loss. Also, at the end of this video, I will show how to remove Linux Mint safely from the dual boot. So make sure to watch the video till to the end to avoid any confusion. Now keep in mind, this method is exclusive to UEFI systems. For those who are using the UEFI or GPT combination on their existing desktop PC or laptop, then this method works flawlessly. As per my testing, if you follow this video carefully, you will be able to successfully dual boot your PC or laptop with Linux Mint. Now to check if your system is running in Avinci boot mode, type msinfo32 inside the run dialog, and under the BIOS mode, it says the status of your computer. Now in my case, my system uses the UEFI boot mode with a GPT formatted drive. Anyway, the prerequisites of this video, you need a Windows 11 or Windows 10 running on your PC or laptop. Next, you need an 8 gigs or higher pen drive to create a bootable disk with Linux Mint. And lastly, you need to reserve a minimum free space of 30 GB or higher from your drive. Now that being said, moving into step number one, open your favorite browser and go to the official website of Linux Mint and download the latest version. By the time of recording this video, Linux Mint 20.3 is the latest version available to be downloaded. In your case, it could be different, but the installation process will be similar. Next up, head over to this website and download Balina HR, which helps in creating a bootable disk with Linux Mint. Now, once it's done downloading all of the files, place them somewhere on your computer for easier navigation. You go ahead and install Balina HR on your computer. Since we are installing Linux Mint alongside Windows 11 on the same drive, you need to allocate a free space for Linux. To do so, open the command prompt, then inside here type this command. Now you can see the Windows Disk Manager. Disk Manager is a special tool in Windows OS that helps to manipulate the drives. Now this will list out all of the connected drives. Now as you can see in my case, only a single drive is visible. Drive 0 is the main SSD where Windows 11 has been installed. If you notice, Drive 0 is using a GPT partition scheme, and you can see all of the partitions. The first partition is known as EFI partition or ESP, which is where the Windows bootloader is present. We will be using the same ESP partition to install a grub bootloader for Linux Mint. Now next to the EFI partition, you can see a C partition where Windows 11 files are located, and the last one is the recovery partition. Now use the C or any other partition to shrink the free space for Linux Mint. To do this, right-click on the desired partition and choose Shrink Volume. Now in my case, I have plenty of space left on my drive. I'm going to allocate 100 GB for Linux Mint. I just type in megabytes. And once it's done, tap on Shrink. This will create a brand new partition, which is called unallocated. Now using this free space, we can install Linux Mint in a moment. Now go ahead, connect the USB drive or pen drive to your PC or laptop, then open Balina HR. Now import the ISO and choose the USB drive. Now in this case, mine is showing as StorageJet. I'm going to choose this option and click on Flash. Now sit back and relax, the process will take some time depending on the writing speed of your USB drive. Now once it's done, reboot your computer. Now while it's rebooting, head over to the BIOS menu by pressing the valid keys on your keyboard. Now in my case, F2 is the key to boot into BIOS. Now inside BIOS, look for Intel Rapid Storage Technology and disable it. Also, make sure to disable the secure boot during the Linux Mint installation just for a moment. And I think Linux Mint can run in a secure boot environment. And anyway, just disable it for a moment. And once you finish installing Linux Mint, you can re-enable secure boot if you need it. So, now save the changes and reboot the system. While it's rebooting, this time hold F2, F10 or F12 to go to the boot menu. Here you can see your USB drive. If you don't see your USB drive over here, make sure you have enabled USB boot inside the BIOS. Now choose your USB drive to boot into the live session of Linux Mint. Now when you're inside the live setup of Linux Mint, you can try it before installing. For now, I'm going to proceed to installation. Now go ahead and click on install option on the desktop. Now set up a system language. Now in my case, I'm going to use English as a default language. Then tap on next. Now for keyboard layout, choose the English United States as a default option. Now enable this option to install any third-party media codecs, graphics, and Wi-Fi drivers. Then click on continue. And next up, it shows the installation screen. If you are a beginner and don't want to mess up all the partitions, you can choose the first option. If in case you are planning to install Linux Mint on a separate drive, you can select the second option. That way, the installer will automatically erase the disk and create a partition for you and install the OS safely. If right now, I'm going to choose something else and show you a more advanced way of creating partitions manually for Linux Mint. Now here you can see all the drives connected to your computer. Now make sure you have selected the internal drive, which in my case is mounted as DevSDA. Under this drive, if you notice, these are Windows partitions, and do not touch any of these, which is going to destroy Windows 11. We're going to use this free space to create only two partitions for Linux Mint. To do so, select the free space and tap on plus button. Then allocate the free space for the root partition, which is considered to be as a main system partition for Linux. For now, I have 100 GB of free space, and I'm going to allocate 90 GB for the root. And as you can see, we have done creating a root partition. Now lastly, we need to create a swap partition. Just go ahead, select the free space left, and use it as a swap area. Make sure under the file system, instead of XT4, choose the swap area, and you don't have to mention any mounting point for this partition. Then tap on OK to create a Linux swap partition. Right now, we are installing Linux Mint on the UEFI system, so by default, it must be having an EFI partition. Now, this is where both Windows and Grub bootloader is located, and the installer will automatically install the Grub bootloader into the system partition. All you have to do is just leave this option as it is. Now, click on install option and accept the changes. Then choose your time zone and create a user account by entering the details. Now sit back and relax. The installation process will take 5 to 20 minutes depending on the writing speeds of your drive. Once it's done, go ahead and restart your computer by removing the bootable media. Now, as you can see, this is the Grub bootloader. From here, you can either boot into Linux Mint or Windows 11. For now, let's just boot into Linux Mint. As a bonus part of this video, if in case you don't like Linux Mint and decide to uninstall, then reboot your computer to Windows 11. Inside Windows 11, open Disk Manager by typing this command on the search bar or inside the command prompt. Here you can see next to C drive, the two partitions which you have created for Linux Mint. Just go ahead and delete these two partitions carefully, one after the other. Once it's deleted, you can see an unallocated free space. You can use this free space in a Windows OS by using an extended volume option. Lastly, we need to do one more important step to remove the grub bootloader from the UEFI partition. For that, we need to take a command prompt help. Just go ahead, open the command prompt with admin rights. Inside here, type disk part, then type list disk. Now, as you can see, this is my main drive. We need to select this drive by typing this command. Then type list partition. It's going to show off the partitions present inside this drive. Now we need to look for a partition named system, also known as UEFI partition. In my case, it's the first one. Select this partition by typing this command. Then assign a drive letter to mount this partition. Now once the drive letter has assigned to the UEFI partition, exit from the disk part. Now type this drive letter with a colon assigned for the UEFI partition. Now type cd UEFI to change the directory into the UEFI partition. Then again type dir to see the contents on this folder. Now here you can see both Windows and Linux bootable files. Right now it's showing us Ubuntu. That's because Linux Mint is Ubuntu based distribution. Anyway, remove this Ubuntu folder by typing this command. Now, this indeed is going to remove all of the grub files related to the Linux Mint. Now, that way you won't end up facing any grub issues. Once it's done, now you have successfully removed Linux Mint from the dual boot. Now restart the computer and you can see the system should boot into Windows 11 without any issues. And that's pretty much it. If in case you like this video, hit the thumbs up down there and don't forget to subscribe to this channel and consider hitting the bell icon to get notified whenever I post a brand new video. Also, if in case you have any suggestions, post them in the comment section down below. Thanks for watching my video. This has been KS Kirayal. I will see you in my next one.